Alright, so today we are going to explain the domain and source. So we will start by using, let's try to open a new file, and we will explain or define this cube as and the domain, and we will move to be in the floor. And I will go to define this one as an domain. So after that, I think there is some cache here, so I will try to delete this cache. After that, I will go to try to make a new cube, and after that, I will define this one as an affiliate. Then I will select the domain and try to make, let's say, this one will be 25 and this one will be around 30, and then I will bake this one. So it's now baking, and we will wait until the baking is finished. So we are now done after baking. I will select. We can now delete the source. So I will now delete the source. We didn't need the source anymore. And I will define it 100, and let's go to the frame 1. And after that, we can, if you play, you will see that this is the fluid. And if you want it to be more resolution, you can increase this final and preview resolution. That was an conclusion or introduction for the simulation inside Blender. Right, so you are now watching the second lesson in our fluid simulation course, and in this lesson we are going to see how we can work with the cache folder. So assume that this is an domain, and I will scale it around 2 times, and after that I will say that we have some fluid which is maybe here, so I will add an UV sphere which may be located inside this place. Then I will define this will be an domain, and after that let's say it will be an domain, and this will be the fluid, of course, our fluid. And if you select the domain, you will see this is the cache folder. So basically the fluid simulation inside Blender doesn't work with in real time, so it's worked inside so it's work as cache in memory, so it doesn't work in real time. Let's explain it in more detail. Assume that you have a timeline here. If you have around 100 and you play, you will not see anything, because this is not like the clothes or any other mechanics. So it's work in by using you should use cache. So I will open this folder, and it will become in temporary here. So basically, if you are done, you can copy this folder in your project file, or copy it in the desktop as you may find suitable for you. But be aware that if you exit the software, you will neglect, or the Blender of course will delete this folder, because it's located inside the theme. So basically, you can choose any folder, your desktop or any folder, and save it. And I suggest that you save it inside your project files, as I say. And this is the final resolution, and this is the preview, and this is the start, and this is the end. So if you say that we have a frame rate of 30, then we have around 5 seconds. Then I will say it will be end in 120. Because we have 4 seconds, and make sure that this number in seconds and this number in frames. This reverse frame will reverse your animation, and this is the speed for your frames. Then I will say that the resolution final will be around maybe 100. 100 is a large number, and if you working with test, you can choose the preview to be maybe 15 or something like this. And if you want to high resolution, you can go up to this number. Right, this is the render display, and this is the viewport display. So this is how you want the fluid to be inside your in your viewport. Then I will cache this and come back later to see what we will. So in this video, we're going to talk about the inflow setting. So here we are inside a new scene, and this will be the domain. So we will select this one and select the fluid setting. Then we will select the flow. It will be the domain, and after that I will select this to be an inflow. So basically we have a circle, and make sure that you have a face inside this circle. Then I will enable some velocity here. So I will say that the x velocity will be 0.4 and y 0.1 and z will 0.1. So basically it will go first in the x axis, and after that it will hit in the other border. If you want to select the both, it will be more visual and more quality, and after that I will add some keyframing for the circle. So I will hit I will say that it will around 150-100, so it's around 5 seconds maybe, and I will say the frame rate will be 30. Then I will select the domain and say that end will be to be 6 seconds, and after that we have the speed. I will increase the speed. Then I will select this one and go to first frame and add location rotation, and after hit location rotation, and we are now done. I think I will go for I will clear this keyframe. And go for 40, and right now we are done. So I will select the domain and pick now. So it has now been finished baking. So I will go for the first frame, and after that I will play. Let's see what we have. So it's now basically it increasing, as you can see. So this is how you can fill any cube. So if you have any cup or cup of water, and you want to fill this cup of water with water or any fluid, you should use inflow. This is the method you can use for filling any surface. If you want to fill it all, you can increase your time, of course. I hope you enjoy this video. See you in the next lesson.